Hi and welcome back. So in this video, let's discuss about project management in Odoo 40. So the project operations in a company will deal with planning, analyzing, organizing, and managing the operations to attain the final results. In certain instances, project operations will be running throughout the company functioning or can be scheduled for a certain time of operations. So the ultimate aim of the project operation is to attain the specified and defined goals with them, which are specified at the initial stage of defining the project. So we have Odoo have project management module that helps the user to manage, verify, and analyze the results of the project operations of the company. So you can see our project module here. So we can create and manage tasks. That is, in project management module, users can create and manage the projects to be operating in the company. So a user can create project managers, employees, and the associated members of the project. Additionally, the task of the project can be defined and the user can assign them to employees to be operating in different time shifts. So a time shift for the respective project can also be defined. So from here you can see all the created projects with few details like project name, then customer of the project, then number of tasks created for each project, then overview and planning. So in overview we can see the recorded hours and profitability of the project. And in planning, that is, it is used to plan project and task and assign to employees. And you can see some of the projects are added to favorites. Like when you click on this star, you can add project to favorites. And it is also possible to see some options. When you click on the three dots, it is possible to share a project. So we can share with multiple recipients. And by adding node, it can be shared. Just click on send test. Then we can change the color of the project. Like when you click on three dots, you can change the color from here. Then we can filter these projects based on a favorites project. You can see all the favorite projects. Then follow projects, my projects, archive projects. We can also add custom filter. And we can group these projects based on project manager, customer, and add custom group. And we can also add save current search. Or we can import projects by clicking this. Then it is also possible to add this project to dashboard. So dashboard is a data management tool. We have a separate module for managing that data management. Then we can also see option in order to edit this project. So we can edit this project configuration. So this can be done from here. And also we can go to configuration, come to configuration. Under configuration, you can see the projects. So from here also, we can edit each project and we can create a new project. So we can create a new project from this dashboard view also, from here also. So before creating a project, let's go to configuration settings and see what are the features available in this project management module. So you can see we have mainly two sections, that is managing task and managing time. So for task management, we have different options like we can enable collaborative pads so that we can edit task description collaboratively in real time. So we can see users interacting in the description and we can see each other's text in distinct color. So enable this option for using that in your project. Then we can set pad server, pad API key here. Then we can also split your task to multiple tasks, that is subtask, to organize your work into sub milestones. Then we can see a feature for customer rating. That is, customers can rate the task. So for that, we can set a rating email template on stages, and using that email template, email can be sent to customers and they can rate on this on task. So while changing stages, this rating can be done, and also periodically. So when you enable this, we can set rating for your project. Then we can see an option that is recurring task. So this is used to auto generate tasks for regular activities. So just enable this in order to make a set task as recurring for your project. Then we have a section for time management. So this section is very important in order to manage time, because we have to deliver the project or task to customers at right time. So for that, we can plan project and task and assign to employees. That is, planning is very essential. So project planning can easily be done in Odoo, where the employees can view the scheduled task, time duration, role, duration of operations. In addition, users can track the resource allocated and the status of each under planning window. So additionally, calendar and Gantt view available allow users to schedule and plan tasks and subtasks accordingly for employees and assign deadlines to each one. So here we can also set timesheet, that is, in order to track time spent on project and task. So we can create timesheet. Then after enabling this set, these options, just save the settings. So I have already enabled these options. Then we can configure project. Then we can create tags. So we can create tags like experiment. So when you create a task, and we can set that task as an experiment, add tag for that task. Then we can also set a tag color. So if you want to create a new tag, just click on create. You can add from here. Then we can see activity types. That is, we can create activity types and use this activity type to schedule activities. So we have done a detailed video on activity types in Odoo 14. So just check that video if you want to know more about it. So after doing this configurations, coming back to our project dashboard, from here, let's create a new project. So I'm going to create a project, my demo, and here can enable planning, that is planning task. Then we can enable timesheet, track time spent on project, and mark it as billable or not. So we can, it is possible to invoice your time spent on task. Then recurring task also can be enabled. So just enable the required options and click create. So when you click create, you can see a page where we can add stages. We have to add stages for our project. Like, we can set new and click add. Then we can also see option, that is, we can find, that is, Odoo provides some examples. So when you click see examples, you can see a lot of Kanban examples. Like for software development, some stages you can see here. Digital marketing, consulting, like this way, you can see different stages. Suppose I'm selecting design. So you can see for design, new request, design, client review, handoff. These are the stages available. So you can use this by clicking use this for my Kanban. So it is automatically added for your project. Then if you want to delete a stage, so for my project, I don't want the stage new. So I just want to just click this delete. So it is removed from the stages. So you can see currently there are four stages, and it is possible to create new tasks for your project. So suppose I'm creating test new, and we can assign it to a user. So you can see mark demo Michelle admin, and we can edit or add this. So I'm not going to edit, I'm just clicking add. So when you click edit, we can make further changes for the project, that is configuration. So it is added to the stage, and we can move this task from new request to design, and it can be moved to client review. So when you move, you can see the count is changing here. Then it is possible to mark this task as important, urgent project. Then we can schedule activity for this task. Here we can schedule activity, so you can see it is scheduled. then it is possible to set it as ready for next stage, and can also block this task. Then from here we can set cover image for this task. So we can upload and set a cover image. Suppose I'm setting an image. So here you can see it is added here. Then we can share this task, can add recipients, a note and send. Then it is also possible to edit, archive, delete, can set color. Then it is also possible to add a task to a stage quickly. Like when you click this quick add, you can quickly add a task. Like this way, you can add test to, click add. So it's added to the stage, design stage. Then it is possible to fold stage. Then we can delete, archive, unarchive, and it's also possible to edit stage. So when we edit stage here, we can set the stage name, email template, rating email template. So we have seen that we have set rating, customer rating option feature in configuration settings. So here we can set an email template, rating email template, and using that template, mail will be sent to customers and they can rate on task when changing stage. Then we can set a different stage description and tooltips. And if you want to set this stage as fold in Kanban default, you can set that also. So I'm not doing that, just saving it. And if you move this to this stage, you can see count changed to 2. We can just click add column to if you want to add new column here. Then we also have list view, then map, then we can see calendar view, pivot view, graph view, then we have Gantt view. We can plan activities here from here. So you can see for Michelle admin for activities planned. Then we can filter this by my task, follow task. You can see a lot of options for filtering. Then we can group it according to stage, project, assign person, and we can add, see some options under favorites. So a task is created for my project. Two tasks are created for my project. Demo new. So coming back to our dashboard, you can see our project, my demo. So you can see two tasks created, and can see planning. We can plan project and task, but we cannot find an option that is overview. So for that, let's edit this project and see what are the options available. So here you can see collaborative pad, that is a description. We can add description, we can change the color, we can make it bold, italic, underline, strike, and we can add bullets. A lot of options are there. We can undo, redo, and it is possible to clear all the ship colors. Then we can switch pad. It is possible to import or export different file formats. Then we can time slider. So when you click on this, you can start timer from here. You can see this version 2, and after that we can return to pad. So you can also see some settings like font type. So when you return to pad, also you can see some settings. Like here we can chat always on screen, show chatting users. You can set font type, language, line numbers. A lot of options are here. Then we can save revision, and we can share and embed this pad. Then we can also see option that is, it shows the users on this pad. So you can see the user is Michelle admin, and from here we can make conversation. Like here we can add conversation, and it's possible to change the color also. Then this is our main part, that is settings. Setting our project, configuring project. So here we can set a project manager. So I have set as Mission Admin, and we can set a customer for this project. Suppose I'm setting CA company, and can see phone number and email is added here. Then you can see analytic account that is used to manage this project. So when you create a project, automatically analytic account will be created with the name of the project. And when you go to external link, we can set the budget items for this project, for this account. Then here comes the main part, visibility. So we can set, we can restrict visibility of the project. So it can be, you can see three options for that. That is, we can make project visible to internal users only. Then we, that is, we can limit this project to invited internal users only. So here we can add internal, allowed internal users. So I've already added Mission Admin. If you want to add more, you can add from here. And then you can see option for all internal users. So all internal users can be, can see this, view this project. Then you can see third option, that is invited portal users and internal users can see this project. That is, it is visible to them. So you can see field to add the allowed portal users. And it's also possible to add followers for this project from here. Then you can add channels. Okay. Then you can see the company. Then timesheet. So this is used to time, log time on task. Then we can see timesheet timer. This is used to track time using a timer. We can start the timer, pause the timer, stop the timer, and after using that, automatically time will be recorded for that task or project. Then we can see an option for billable. And that is whether this project is billable or not. So when you enable this, we can invoice your time and material to customers. And when you enable this option, you can see a different option here, that is products on task. So you can track material used to complete task. And also you can see an additional tab for invoicing. So here we can make settings for invoicing, that is invoice tasks to different customers or unique customer. So we can invoice tasks to different customers and set a service product here. And we can also create invoice to unique customer. Then here we can set the pricing. So pricing can be done project rate or employee rate. So when you select this, you can set the sale order, default sale order item for this project. Then when you choose employee rate, you can see an additional tree view here. Here we can add the employees, sale order item, then we can set a unit price. So this is the invoicing part. So we have to enable billable option, then only you can see that. Then we have option for customer rating. So we have enabled that option in settings, configuration settings. So customers can rate on a task or project. So rating can be done like when changing stage or when or periodical rating. So we can set the rating template here on stages. So we have seen that how we can set that. Then if you choose the second option, periodic rating, then if rating frequency, we can set, that is periodically we can, customers can rate on task. That can be done weekly, twice a month, once a month, yearly, quarterly. Okay, then so I'm setting this one. Then you can see option for planning. That is, plan your resources on project task. You can see this collaborative pads is already enabled. So we can make this collaborative pad available to internal users and portal users. Okay, then we can see option for subtask, enable that. Then we can see option for recurring task. So we can auto-generate task for regular activities. So after changing this, you can save the project. So when you save this, you can see option to share, then create sale order from here. And you can see the number of documents, attachments for this project, number of tasks created, total time recorded, hours recorded. Then we have a project overview. We can see project overview. So this option is only available when you enable this billable. Then we can also see the forecasted hours. Then when you come back to our dashboard also, you can find option for overview. So before going to that, let's click on planning and see how we can plan projects or tasks and assign to employees. So from here you can see filtered by my demo project, and from here we can see today's planning, and we can see the planning day wise, week wise, month wise, year wise. We can copy previous week, and we can also send schedule. After adding the planning, we can send the schedule to employees. So by clicking add button, we can add project planning. So here we can select the employee name, then role and project is automatically added here. Then we can set the task, then we can make mark as repeat. So when you mark it as repeat, we can repeat it. It can be repeated every week, every 2 week or 1 week, and can be repeated forever or until a particular date. And we can set that date here. Then below, above, you can see the shift templates for this employee. And here we can set the planning. So I have applied date here, plan dates, and the allocated time for this project. So you can see the allocated time in percentage and allocated hours, then effective hours. So when you start, that is when some time is spent on the project or task, this hours will change. And you can see the initially planned hours. So this is given, this initially planned hours is given when you create a, that is given inside the task. Then you can see forecast hours, number of hours already forecast for this task and its subtask. And it is also possible to save this template, and you can save this planning from here, or publish and send, or we can publish it. So this, I'm just saving it. So when it is saved, you can see open shift for employee Antina Oliva. You can see from this date to this date a project is assigned, and you can see the few details here. And it is also possible to add new one, just click on the plus. And here when you open the existing plan, you can see four other shift for this employee at the same time. So total shift can be seen for this employee. And it is also possible to send the schedule. So here we can see that a lot of employees are added here. So from here we can select new employees and add additional message along with this planning. And we can enable open shift and then send and publish. For this, so this is the default view, that is Gantt view. We have list view and pivot view for our project planning. And we can filter it according to open shift. A lot of options are shown here. Then group by, you can see view date. So you can see this project is planned. This task is planned. Okay, so let's come back to our project, and then create a new sale order for this project. So let's open our sales module, and here let's create a new quotation. So I'm adding Azure Interior. Then here I can add a product. So product must be a service product, because we are creating sale order for a service product, that is our task. So just go to external link. And here we can, okay, let me change this. And here I can set the product type as service. Then here I can set a public price, 100. Then under sales, you can see, find some options for invoicing. So this, these two options are available only if you set this product type as service. So you can see service invoicing policy, three options. Prepaid, that is on ordered quantity. Then you can see timesheet on task. Then milestone. So timesheet on task means invoicing is done based on the employee timesheet, time spent on the work task. Then we can see third option, that is manually set quantities on order. So if a part of the task is done and it can be invoiced, and the remain can be invoiced later. Then we can see service tracking, so that is can track service by without creating task, create a task in existing project, or create a task in sale orders project, or create a new task but a new project but no task. So I'm selecting create a task in sale orders project. So with the name of the sale order, a new project will be created, and you can save this. So when you save, you can see the product is added here. Here we can set the unit price. So I have set the invoicing policy as based on timesheet. Then can save this and confirm this. So when you confirm, you can see here one task is created, and we can also see the project overview. So when you click on this task, you can see the task here. So when you edit this, you can see the task name, project name. Then we can set a person, so we can assign to a person. We can set a parent task, tags can be assigned as a new feature. Then we can mark it as recurrent. We can see the customer is already added while creating the sale order. We can see the phone number, sale or sales order item. Then we can add description, and here we can add the timesheet. So we can manually add timesheet, that is the work spent, time spent on the task manually from here. Before that, let's add initial plan hours, adding 5. Then here we can add the time manually from here. Then here we can add the duration spent. So I'm adding 2 hours. So when you add 2 hours, you can see progress is 40% as the initial plan hours is 5 hours. And this is manually. So we have added manually the plan, that is the timesheet. We can also add it automatically, like just click on start. And then click pause or stop. So when you stop, and here we can add a CC, the duration, description can be added, it is not mandatory. So when you add that, here we can see one line is added automatically with the duration, and you can see progress has changed. So we can create subtasks for this task. Then we can see the sale order, then number of products attached, then the forecast. So we have created that. Then you can see the number of hours recorded has changed from here. Then we can create invoice directly from here, or we can create invoice by going to project overview. So when you go to project overview, so let me open my project module, and here you can see project is created with a sale order. You can see one task. So just click on this overview, and there you can see our recorded hours. Here we can see it is billed on timesheet. You can see the hour spent and the percentage rate, and you can see two invoice amount from here. and we can see the total profitability. So profitability is calculated by adding invoice plus two invoice and then timesheet cost. So this timesheet cost is calculated based on the time spent by the employee on the task. And we can set the cost per hour for employee in the HR settings from employee module. So we can also see some other option like billed at fixed price, non-billable task, and one more is there, that is no task found project. So we have done videos on different types of projects available in Odoo 14, then profitability in Odoo 14 project. So please check those videos if you want to know more about this. And so here you can see the total hours spent on the project, and below you can see the work done by employees, hours spent by employee, the progress, and you can see the type of project here, and you can see timesheet and planning of this project, remaining hours. Then we can see the number of tasks, late task, overtime task, sale orders, number of sale orders created, then number of time spent, and we can create directly invoice from here. Create regular invoice. We can set a timesheet period from here and then create invoice. So we can create and view invoice from here. So just confirm it and register payment. So we have created invoice for the recorded time, that is time spent by employee. So here you can see invoice is changed and the profitability is increased. So in this way you can see profitability and time spent on project. Then we can also see all the tasks created. So by default, you can see the task as list view. So here you can see title of task, then project name under which the task is created, then the person to which the task is assigned, responsible person, then the company name, then the hours spent. So here you can see the hours spent and progress of each task in percentage. And we can plan next activity from here. You can see the plan activities too, then the tags given for the task, then the stage, so these are the details that are shown in the view, and we have a Kanban view, calendar view, so you can see different views from here, we have seen it before. Then we have reporting for a project. So under reporting you can see task analysis. So we can analyze the task. Here we can see different measures like task, day to deadline, effective hours, planned hours. We can select the measure from here, one measure from here. And we can see different views like pie chart, bar chart, line chart. Then you can see, we can order this task analysis in ascending or descending order. And we can see a lot of filtration options, that is based on assigned date, last stage date. We can filter this, that is analyze the task, and we can group it according to project, assigned person and stage. So for this task analysis, we also have a pivot view. So from here, we can insert the task analysis to spreadsheet. So it is really helpful, which is a new option that is found in Odoo 14 project, sorry, Odoo 14. Then we have a new reporting, that is for analyzing timesheet and planning. So we have, we can analyze based on different measures like difference, effective hours, number of hours, and count. And we have different views from here. So we can group it by employee and task. So you can see the time spent, effective hours, planned hours by each employee on task. Then we have customer rating report. So you can see all the reports, that is, so we can analyze our company's performance, that is by looking at this customer rating. So you can see two customers satisfied with the project of his design, and can see highly dissatisfied for this project research development. And you can see different views for this customer ratings. Then we also have project cost and revenues. So we can see the cost spent on projects, and we can see the revenues of got from the projects. So here we can see for each month in 2020, can see the untaxed amount invoice, amount invoiced, timesheet cost, timesheet duration, and from here we can change the measure. We can add measures like other revenues, other cost for project, and can see count. So we can add details here, and this amount and count will be changed on time. So you can insert this report to spreadsheet by clicking on this insert in spreadsheet. So you can manage a record, that is, of this report. So if you want to group this according to project manager, customer, you can do that and add filtrations. So in this way we can so these are all the reportings available for our project module. So that's all about project management in Coda 14. If you're interested in knowing more about this or looking for any Coda implementation or customization in your business, drop your request to Coda@cyprosys.com.